हेलो, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल दैट इज़ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग। आज के इस वीडियो में हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे ड्रिलिंग मशीन ऑपरेशंस, मींस विच आर द पॉसिबल ऑपरेशंस दैट वी कैन परफॉर्म ओवर द ड्रिलिंग मशीन। सो वी विल बिगिन विद द इंट्रोडक्शन। सो मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट मशीन टूल्स इन द वर्कशॉप नेक्स्ट टू द लेथ मशीन। सो ड्रिलिंग मशीन इज़ नथिंग बट द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट मशीन टूल्स इन द वर्कशॉप नेक्स्ट टू द लेथ। So in workshop there are various machines like lathe machine, milling machine, drilling machine, boring machine, shaper, planer, grinder. These are nothing but different machines which are available in the workshop, and the drilling machine is the most important machine tools in the workshop next to the lathe machine. It is primarily designed to originate the hole. So the purpose of drilling machine is to originate the hole inside the workpiece. It can also perform a number of similar operations. So other than drilling, it can perform various operations, and those operations we will discuss in this presentation. Then hole may be drilled quickly at a low cost. So with the use of drilling machine, we can quickly drill the hole at very low cost. Hole is generated by rotating edge of a cutting tool known as drill, which exerts large force on the work clamped on the table. So basically in drilling process, the drilling is done with the help of a cutting tool known as drill bit. That cutting tool, that is drill bit, has a cutting edge, and that cutting edge exerts a force over the workpiece to originate the hole inside the workpiece. Okay, so this is nothing but an image of drilling machine. So here you can see a motor. Generally it is a three-phase induction motor, and that motor is connected to the spindle with the help of belt drive. This is nothing but the handle with which you can move the spindle up and down. So this handle is used basically for moving the spindle or for moving the cutting tool up and down. With this handle we can adjust the table. Again, with this handle also we can adjust the table of the drilling machine. This is nothing but a table of drilling machine. Over this table we can clamp the workpiece with the help of vise. So here this is nothing but your drilling machine. Now we will discuss one by one which are the possible operations that we can perform over the drilling machine. So very first operation, that is drilling. Second operation, reaming. Third operation, boring. Fourth operation, counter boring. Fifth operation, counter sinking. Sixth, spot facing. Seventh, tapping. Eighth, lapping. And ninth, trepanning. So these are some possible operations which we can perform over the drilling machine. So the very first operation, that is drilling. So it is an operation of producing a cylindrical hole by removing the metal by rotating edge of a cutting tool called as drill. So drilling, it is nothing but an operation of producing a cylindrical hole. We can produce a cylindrical hole with the drilling process. Now the hole can be machined with the help of a cutting tool known as drill bit. This is nothing but a drill bit which has a flutes over its periphery and a cutting edge at the bottom. This cutting edge originates the holes because it exerts a force over the workpiece and it removes the material from the workpiece. Before drilling, the center of the hole is located on the workpiece by drawing two lines at right angle to each other. Now, before drilling process, what is done? First, you have to complete the marking process. How marking is done? You have to draw two different lines which are perpendicular to each other, and the intersection that will give the location for the drilling. Okay, so before drilling, the center of the hole is located on the workpiece by drawing two lines at right angle to each other, and then center punch is used to produce an indication at the center. After marking, the next process, that is known as punching. And for punching process, a center punch is used. That punching process is done to means what we can say, it is nothing but an indication which shows the center. Okay, then the drill point is pressed at this center point to produce the required hole. So the very first process, that is marking. After marking, the punching is done, and after that the drilling is done. How the drilling is done? The drill point. So this drill bit has a two cutting edge. These are nothing but the two cutting edge of this drill bit, and intersection of those cutting edges, there we can get a cutting point. Okay, so the drill point is pressed at this center point to produce the required hole. So here you can see a drilling process. So this is nothing but a drill bit, and it is a rotary member, and the workpiece is fixed over the table of the machine, and then it has a web and the leap. Leap are nothing but the two cutting edges of the drill bit. Now the next operation, that is known as reaming. It is an accurate way of sizing and finishing a hole which has been previously drilled. So after drilling, the next operation is done, that is known as reaming. It is nothing but a finishing operation. So the speed of the spindle is made half that of the drilling, and automatic feed may be employed. So during reaming, the speed of the spindle is made half as compared to drilling, because it is a finishing process and we have to remove very less material during the reaming process, and hence the speed of the spindle is made half that of the drilling. The tool used for reaming is known as reamer, which has multiple cutting edge. So this is nothing but an image of reamer. Here you can see the reamer has multiple cutting edges over its periphery, and with this cutting edges we can remove the material over the periphery of the inner hole. So here you can see a process of reaming. So basically with the reaming we can remove the material from the periphery of the hole. So from here we can remove the material because the reamer has a cutting edge over its periphery, and with this cutting edge we can remove the material. The next operation, that is known as boring. So to enlarge a hole by means of an adjustable cutting tool with only one cutting edge. So in boring operation, basically boring operation is performed for enlarging a previously drilled hole. So the prerequisite for the boring operation is you should have a previously drilled hole, and that you can enlarge with the help of boring tool. So the boring tool has only one cutting edge, and with that cutting edge the material is removed from the inner surface of the hole. The cutter is held in a boring bar which has a taper shank to fit into the spindle socket. So basically the cutting tool is held in a boring bar, and then it is rotated, and while rotating it removes the material from the inner surface of the hole. So here you can see the boring operation. Now this is the boring bar, the boring tool, and here you can see the boring tool. This is nothing but the boring tool, and to this boring tool a single point cutting tool is attached. Now this single point cutting tool removes the material from the periphery of this hole, and hence we can enlarge a previously drilled hole. For perfect finishing a hole, the job is drilled slightly undersized. So first the job is drilled undersize, and then the material is removed with the boring operation so as to get a perfect hole. The next operation, that is fourth operation, is counter boring. It is a cylindrical flat bottom hole that enlarges another axial hole or the tool used to create the feature. This is necessary in some cases to accommodate the heads of the bolts, stud and the pin. The tool used for counter boring is called as counter bore. So here you can see an image of counter boring operation. So this is nothing but a counter bore tool which is basically used for counter boring operation. So now with this tool we can remove the material like this. And why it is performed? Because we have to machine a space That space is used to accommodate the heads of the bolt, stud and pin. So here you can place nut and bolt easily. Okay, and for that purpose counter boring is done. So just neglect this image, because this is not a counter boring operation, but this is a counter boring operation. So after performing a counter boring operation, the workpiece will look like this. So this is all about your counter boring operation, and this is necessary in some cases to accommodate the heads of the bolt, stud and pins, and for that purpose only counter boring operation is done. Now the next operation is counter sinking. So it is an operation of making a cone shape enlarged of the end of the hole to provide a recess for a flat head screw or countersunk rivet fitted into the hole. So this is nothing but a counter boring operation. Counter boring is performed to accommodate the heads of the bolt, stud and pin. Now this is a counter sinking operation. The difference is we made a conical shape feature at the end of the hole. Now this is nothing but a conical shape feature which is made with the help of counter sinking operation. Okay, why it is done? It provides a recess for a flat head screw or countersunk rivet fitted into the hole. So here you can see, now this conical feature is made here. The conical feature is made here, and now in this conical feature we can attach a screw, and these are nothing but difference countersinking tools with which we can perform a countersinking operation. So the standard countersunk have 60 degree, 82 degree or 90 degree included angle, and the cutting edges of the tool are formed at the conical surface. So this is all about your counter sinking operation. Now the next operation is spot facing. It is the operation of smoothing the surface around a hole for a seat, for a nut or the head of the screw. A counter bore or a special spot facing tool may be employed for this purpose. So here you can see a spot facing operation. Now in spot facing operation, the material around the hole is being removed. Okay, so it is the operation of smoothing the surface around the hole for the seat of nut or head of the screw. So here you can easily place a washer, or it is nothing but a seat for the nut or the head of the screw. Okay, and for this purpose either you can use a counter bore tool. So here I have used a counter bore tool for a spot facing operation, or you can use a special spot facing tool for the spot facing purpose. The next operation, that is known as tapping. It is the operation of cutting internal threads by means of a cutting tool called as tap. A tap may be considered as a bolt with accurate thread on it. The thread act as cutting edge which are hardened and ground. So here you can see a tapping operation. Now tapping is nothing but producing an internal threads inside the hole. So this is nothing but a tap. A tap is similar to the bolt having external threads cut over its periphery. So these are nothing but different taps, and with this tap we can remove the material inside the hole, and basically tapping operation is performed for producing internal threads. Okay, so after tapping operation your workpiece will look like this. So it is basically used for cutting the internal threads inside the hole. Now so a tap may be considered as a bolt with accurate thread cut on it. So the tap is similar to the bolt, but the difference is there are threads cut over its periphery, and it is basically used for cutting the threads. Okay, the thread acts as a cutting edge which are hardened and ground. So the threads are nothing but the cutting edge for this tool. So it has to be very hard, so it has to be hardened first and then it has to be used. So this is all about your tapping operation. The next operation is lapping. It is the operation of sizing and finishing a small diameter hole already hardened by removing a small amount of material by using lap. The copperhead laps are commonly used. The lap fits in the hole and is moved up and down while it revolves. So this is an example of lapping machine. Here you can see a table, and on this table some rings are placed. Three different rings are placed. Okay, so the workpiece is to be placed inside this ring, and then this portion. So here you have to keep your workpiece. So inside this ring you have to keep this, keep the workpiece, and then this is known as lap tool. These are nothing but lap tool. It can move up and down. So after placing the workpiece inside the ring, then the lap tool is pressed against that workpiece, and then this drum rotates. Okay, and at the bottom of this drum, or this surface, this is nothing but an abrasive surface. Okay, so the workpiece is kept inside the ring, and then the lap tool is pressed against that wheel or against the workpiece, and then this drum is rotated. Due to the abrasive particle, there is an abrasion in between the workpiece and this abrasive wheel, and then the material is removed from the surface of the workpiece. So basically, lapping is a super finishing operation where very less material is removed from the surface of the workpiece and we are getting a finished surface. The last operation, that is nothing but trepanning. It is an operation of producing a hole by removing the metal along the circumference of a hollow cutting tool. So whenever we want to produce a hole with large diameter, it can be produced by using a trepanning operation. Now suppose if we want to drill a hole with say a 500 mm diameter, so it is not possible to drill a hole with 500 diameter by using a drill bit, because that time we have to manufacture a drill bit with 500 mm diameter, and which is not possible practically. So for this purpose we can perform a trepanning operation. Now in trepanning, this is nothing but a trepanning tool. So the trepanning tool has two different cutting tools. The trepanning tool has two different cutting tools. These are nothing but the two cutting tools, and this tool moves along its periphery. Now it can move along the periphery. Okay, so here you can see this is a trepanning tool, and it has two cutting edge over its periphery, and this cutting tool can rotate along its own axis, and the axial feed is given to this cutting tool. As the feed is given, it will remove the material over the circumference, and we can produce a hole inside the workpiece. Okay, so trepanning operation is performed for producing a larger hole. Okay, so this is the basic difference between drilling and trepanning. Whenever we want to produce a hole with diameter, that time we can use trepanning operation. Fewer chips are removed and much of the material is saved while the hole is produced. So while drilling operation, the material is removed in form of chips, and which is not useful. Okay, whereas in trepanning operation, very less material is removed from the workpiece, and then we can get a blank from the workpiece. So this operation is similar to blanking operation, whereas the blanking operation is done on the press machine, and we can perform trepanning operation over the drilling machine. So these are nothing but 9 different operations which we can perform over the drilling machine. Thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you so much.